Hello, I'm Chaudhary Rajinder Nijjhar, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Here I present a discussion on Shiva, the Lord of the Universe. Shiva, or Shiv, is head of the triune, demiurges. They are gods. First is Brahma, the creator of universe, including male and female, and in the Middle East they call him Yahweh. Vishnu is a moral teacher, while Shiva lords over the universe or the creation, like a king rules over his subject. Thus, what you see with your two naked eyes is the creation of Brahma or Yahweh. Whilst what you cannot see but perceive, for example, soul, is a Paar Brahm, our God. Our real self is a soul. Whilst we have a clothing of a human being, could be of any other living thing. Brahmins and Rabis, as the moral teachers, we call them Guru, are concerned with our physical selves, which we call in Punjabi TANN. Whilst in this dark age, Satguru appear to guide our souls through spiritual preaching called Gospel for MUNN or mind. Vishnu, demiurge, gives us education to lead our moral lives, and Shri Ram Chander Ji and Moses in the Middle East were the incarnation of Vishnu, and therefore he was known as MURYADA PARSHOTAM AVTAR. That means who is giving the principles of living in this world, moral laws, that's Torah. In a nutshell, Vishnu opens our third eye of knowledge so that we may lead our lives in peace. Finally, Shiva, demiurge, supports the righteous people and fights to kill the oppressors. This he does keeping in mind the moral laws of Vishnu, represented by the third eye placed in the middle of the three horizontal frontal marks. Shri Krishan Baldev Ji was the incarnation of Shiv, and he had to give a visual illustration to the simpleton Yadavs that he is the Lord of the universe and they should do as he commands of them. So Shiva is Lord of the universe like a king, and kings have policies or nitis to put into practice. That is why Shri Krishan Baldev Ji was called a NEETI PARSHOTAM AVTAR. Now let us ponder over his appearance. He has a snake around his neck, reminding us that in politics your deadly enemies are as close to you as a snake around your neck. Then a king has to feed his subject, and water is needed to grow the crops. Ganges surpasses all the other rivers in India in the supply of water. So that honor of growing crops goes to River Ganges. Whilst in protecting his subject from the enemies, the honor goes to the people of Jatt tribe, as their elder Vir Bhaddar Yadev took the revenge of the death of one of Shiva's three wives. For that, Vir Bhaddar Yadev was honored as one of his Jatt. Jatt means the head hair locks. That is why sometimes Jatt Sadhus would say that they are the brothers of River Ganges. In this dark age, Sache Pasha Har Gobind Ji undertook the spiritual work of Shiv and Pai Buddha Ji, a Randhawa Jatt, to his spiritual sister Mata Ganga Ji, wife of Satguru Arjan Dev Ji, blessed his birth. The hue of Shiv is blue, as the color of the sky is blue, and that is why the dress of Khalsas is also blue. Shiv, being the master of the universe as a lion, is the king of the jungle, so he put on a lion's skin as his dress, and the Khalsas, the Paar Shiv Sena, are also addressed as Singh, meaning lions, under the command of none but Waheguru, the third eye of Gospel of Gobind. That is why Khalsas are the soldiers of Akaal Purakh and not of any secular kings. They fight for the righteousness, whether the victim of the oppression is an Indian or not. They are above tribes, and they do not take sides, but they are impartial. Their true thrones are Khalistans. Further, Shiv is said to have meditated at the source of Ganges, which is Hem Kund. Sache Pasha Gobind Singh Ji was the spiritual incarnation of Paar Shiv. As a king is normally the head of a tribe dominating that country, Lingam is worshipped in honor of the tribal seed in order to remain faithful to one's tribe. Union is also given importance, as without a woman there is no procreation. With the grace of Allah, you acquire Al-Kitaab of Al-Islaam. Al-Islaam is Islam of Allah, but this Islam, the present one, is not the Islam of Allah, but it is the Islam of Mullah, or we call it of Moon. The sun, the Al-Islam is the Islam of sun, the primary source of light. Gnostics are the living Christ, which we call in Punjabi Satgurus, and not Christians of living Allah. Allah is same as God, because the word Allah originates from Illa. Illa used to be tribal gods at Kaaba. They were around 300 to 400 tribal gods. So Al-Illa means the Father, which is God. Spirit, Allah is spirit. Remember that to your three gurus, mother who feed you up, bring you up, looks after you, father who protects you and teaches you the trade skills, and pandit who give you political education, you render money. To your Satguru or Christ Nanak Dev Ji or Christ Jesus, you render your mann or mind. You give your mind to that. That means you go by the preachings of Christ. And to your Sache Pasha Gobind Singh Ji, you render your son or physical body as sacrifice. Such is bitter, but it leads you to heaven, while Sat is extremely bitter, but it leads you to Anand or salvation. Falsos or Kur are extremely sweet, MAKHAEON MITHHA, sweeter than honey, but they lead you to hell. God bless you. Thank you.